Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 2005 Christmas Party. Tonight, I have a lot of things to show you, and I hope it keeps you all entertained. Here are just a few highlights of tonight's show. We'll see some scenes from last year's flying and take a helicopter ride around the field. We'll see Rich prepare for the big flight. And then there's this year's cleanup party. The lawnmower gets stolen, the Boy Scouts came to have some fun, and someone gets really bugged. You'll see 86 races. There's the kids and Becky, the Jenny, securing our shed, the training program, a tour of our members' airplanes, the club picnic, and someone grabbed my camera. Ugh. Okay, let's start things off with our fun fly last year. We registered to fly, and then we went on to safety inspections. And we got a brief lesson from Glenn on how safety comes first. All right, brief enough. And now the best part of a fly-in, flying. Now we get to watch Glenn fly. We're gonna watch him fly. Maybe not. Moving on. Are you ready yet? Come on, let's go. No, I'm not ready. Oh, you look all right. Come on, let's go. On your mark. Get set. Wait, push me out. Oh, all right. Gonna start. You watch. I can tell. It's gonna start. You watch. You hear it? We'll get back to you later.
Signature landing.
Now it's time for the big raffle with lots of great prizes. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the New Hampshire Flying Tigers Helicopter Tours. My name is Roger, and I will be your tour guide for this flight. Please fasten your seatbelts and enjoy the tour. Our first stop is at the north end of the field. Not only do we have happy club members, but our field is smiling from ear to ear. Some of the new club members may think those are power lines, but we refer to them as gear removers.
No!
This is the spot where my good friend Freddy thought it was too hot to be flying and decided to go for a swim.
Ee-abba-dabba-doo!
I've seen a lot of our members go too far out on the final approach, and they always wind up in the same tree.
Watch out for that!
Call this area the Northwest Passage. There seems to be a flow of air through here that draws the airplanes through, and a lot of them wind up in this tree. That's where someone found Ian's airplane. Gentlemen, here is your very skillful pilot, Rich Bono. And over here, where everyone is huddled around the video receiver, John Lavery is holding the transmitter that controls the camera's servos. Will Widgren is also standing there with his camcorder connected to the video receiver. That is how this tour became possible. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our helicopter tour. Thank you for flying with the New Hampshire Flying Tigers. Please remain seated for the rest of the show.
Since you have not performed your field maintenance duties this year, you owe an additional $40 in maintenance fees to renew your membership.
What? Not again?
I was there.
Let's get a picture. Oh, right here. Is it on a date there?
Nice.
Do you ever have a problem?
Yes, every year.
Okay.
And I'm here too.
All right.
We had a pretty good turnout for the spring cleanup. Everyone was working pretty hard with all the usual camaraderie.
Hey, where's the nearest outlet?
There's Bill Horton feeding the chickens. After all the work was done, it was time to try out our newly groomed field. Our club hosted an event with the Boy Scouts last spring. We started the day off with an orientation. John Lavery did a very professional presentation of our club activities, taught them how our airplanes work and how they are built. We had a good variety of airplanes to show them, and Hans even brought some of his larger scale aircraft. The static display was followed by flight demos. Here's proof that the Delta Wing did fly. After we all had lunch, it was time to let them try their hand at flying. We really have to thank the volunteers who spent about 4 hours helping each kid on the buddy box. The day was a real success. What's this? Rich with an airplane? Oh my! Clearly his helicopter's jealous and won't leave his side. Okay, while we wait for the big airplane flight, let's see how the training program is coming along. The training program got ramped up this year with a lot of new members. Our professional staff of instructors will train anyone regardless of age, creed, or color. They'll even train the vertically challenged.
I can barely reach the sticks.
As you may know, there aren't many female pilots in this hobby, so I thought it would be a good idea to interview the latest female pilot in training. But my first attempt didn't go so well.
Hey, can I get an interview, Jenny?
No, and my name isn't Jenny, it's Becky.
Oh.
Well, I'll try again later. In the meantime, let's meet some of the other new members.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
What's your name?
Steve Ham.
And when did you start?
This will be my fourth night of training.
Well, good. Welcome aboard.
Yeah, well, I crashed it the first couple of nights, but I haven't crashed it the last two, so I'm making progress.
That's it. Progress is all you can ask for. Are you thoroughly hooked yet, or what?
Oh, pretty much so.
Yeah.
Yeah, it didn't take long. I'd seen a feature article in the Derry newspaper showing Rich Bono and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And that's what prompted me to come down and check this out.
All right. Paul, which of those elements is Raisonium?
It's under R.
Under R.
Yes, right there.
And your name is?
Mike.
How long you been flying?
Not long.
How long?
About 3 months.
How you doing?
Good.
Feeling pretty confident?
Sort of.
Before you know it, it'll become second nature.
Hopefully.
Yeah, it will. Okay, can I get an interview now?
No.
Why not?
Because.
Flying for 2 weeks now?
No, 3 months.
3 months?
Yes.
Oh, well, you're doing pretty good for 3 months.
I am.
Hey, And here we have the Raison Pit Crew.
Should have seen his face.
Right. It goes on after the prompt is.
So I noticed you were flying solo.
Uh-huh.
When did you start that?
About 2 months ago, maybe.
So how are you doing?
Pretty good.
So I heard your favorite color was orange.
Careful.
That's not what I heard. I heard it was orange.
They just came in.
Pink.
I got two of them.
Oh, so your favorite color is pink.
Only second.
Second. Oh, well, how come you don't always dress in purple?
I don't have a lot of purple.
Yeah.
Hmm, what is she reading? How you doing?
Good.
You got your name on the list for some flying?
No, no? I don't fly. I stay on the ground. Yes.
Okay, time for some important lessons while you're training. Always keep an eye on your airplane. Hey, did you hear what I just said? Keep an eye on your airplane. There you go. And never let the bugs get to you. Always bring lots of bug spray. Case in point.
Oh, no, the bug! Oh, the bug! Oh! Hey, what are you doing? Look at your airplane! Radio's backwards!
And never get discouraged, because there's always going to be a few mishaps. And if you think it'll help, a little prayer doesn't hurt.
Bless you, my son. Bless you, my airplane.
And when you have a successful flight, it's not necessary to bow. And most important lesson of all, always look out for the cameraman. I'm sure we all heard enough about the stolen lawnmower, so I won't go into that. What we never hear is the upside of it all. Since those two sinister types did the dirty deed, we've had an increase in membership. Participation is up. Our training program is more organized. We now have control over the field, and we took in a good chunk of change in donations toward the new mower. Although our shed is now insured, Becky and I came up with a new idea.
Okay, this is our idea of securing the new lawnmower.
All right, Becky, go ahead and hit the button. All right, that was cool. I hope we can get it back up. Let's see how Rich is making out with that airplane.
Sean, you just came here to watch the planes? Yeah? How do you like them?
Good.
Yeah? All right.
He's just taking off right now.
Yeah. Well, we'll have to film him, huh?
My dad has one that only goes.
Sean and his dad spotted our planes while they were riding their ATVs. I think Glenn just made a new friend.
It's gonna start. And what happens when it starts?
They don't take much.
It gets scared because it makes noise. It makes lots of noise. Okay. One again. It's okay.
How old are you?
2, 3.
What color is your airplane? You have a red airplane?
3. Wow.
How many times has Daddy crashed? 3, that's it?
You're Sarah? Yeah. I thought you were Lisa.
It wasn't.
You wasn't?
No.
No. You're not Linda?
No.
No?
She is.
No. What's her name?
Mary.
Mary. What are you going to do when you grow up?
I'm flying a helicopter.
You gonna fly a helicopter?
Yeah.
Are you gonna fly airplanes?
Yeah, I'm gonna grow up.
When you grow up?
When you grow up.
So next year?
Next year, yeah. Right? Yeah.
What other little girl do you know who flies airplanes?
Yeah.
What's her name?
Becky.
Yeah.
Becky. What is she doing behind me? Oh.
I'm gonna fly a helicopter.
Yeah.
You guys gonna fly helicopters together?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, my daddy's gonna fly me and I'm gonna fly him.
You're not gonna share?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you're gonna share with daddy?
Mm-hmm. All right, let's see what Rich is up to.
The thrill of victory. The agony of defeat.
There they are, the New Hampshire Flying Tigers Pylon Racing Team. And the little one you see there is John Lavery. Okay, we're keeping an eye on John. He's been known to jump the gun before, so watch that starting line. Hello, he's done it again, as everyone struggles to try and overtake him. Here comes Jay from the 495th, and oh, he just misses the cameraman, and he goes down, and he's out of the race. There's Steve falling to last place. Ian slides into first place as they go around the third pylon. And Steve overtaking the guys from the 495th. John still trying to take back the lead as he pulls in behind Ian. Oh, and John is down and he's out of the race. The boys of the 495th pulling in to fill in the gap as they come around for the final lap. Ian pours it on toward the finish line as he streaks across the line like a bolt of lightning to win the first race.
And Ian was the winner.
Right.
And who came in second?
Mike.
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 And
oh, fine.
Chris. Very good guy.
Where's your plane?
It's over there. Someone else is flying it.
Yeah. Nice of you to show up here.
Hey, nice of you to have me.
A fine steamer of an August day.
Dog days of summer.
That's it.
Yep.
Glad you can make it and do some flying with us.
Yep. Happy to be here.
All right.
Daryl was complaining about our short runway, but he says it's the widest one he's ever seen.
What's under the kilt?
Oh! Jeez!
Oh! But she keeps it running!
We'll be right back.
Okay, John, show the hands.
I knew it! So there really is such thing as gremlins.
How did it survive the landing?
Oh, don't hurt him.
All right.
No
his videos.
Hey, Bob LaPointe picked up this really cool ARF of an F-82. Want to guess who's flying this airplane? I'll give you a hint. The wheels are facing the sky. Hey, John, you did such a good job with the test flight. Go ahead and take a bow. Ah! Turned out to be a pretty nice day for our picnic, and a lot of people showed up, which can only mean a lot of fun.
There'll be no training until John can land the GB correctly. Thank you.
Yes, I got it. It's a four-legged airplane.
Go ahead. Oh, yeah. It's inverted all the time.
Now, John has a unique way of landing this aircraft.
There, right, John!
Yeah. Playing the front side down!
He also has a unique way of turning the engine off. Time for a tour of our members' airplanes. Looks like Rich is all set to go. With an airplane that big, who needs taxiways? They were having so much fun, they both went dead stick at the same time.
I wonder it wouldn't come off.
I'm sorry I missed the great shot, but keep an eye on the shadows.
Here I come.
Oh, no.
Somebody else is coming through.
Oh!
And watch this as Bob Kilman lands his airplane on one wheel. Some of our club members are also members of the New Hampshire Aviation Historical Society. They asked for volunteers to build a model for the new museum at the Manchester Airport. So a group of us got together and built this scale model of the Curtiss Jenny. This particular model was the very first airplane to land at the Manchester Airport. It was flown by a pilot by the name of Robert Fogg. The gentleman you see signing our airplane is Robert Fogg Jr., and the young man next to him is Eric Lindbergh, the grandson of Charles Lindbergh. He signed our airplane as well. It was all part of the ribbon-cutting ceremony for the new Aviation Museum. The museum is actually the original terminal building built in the 1930s. Our airplane now hangs in the glass tower. It's the first airplane you see when you pull into the parking lot. It gave us a sense of pride to be part of history. See if you can guess who it is who kept pointing the camera back at me.
Hey, what are you doing? Cameraman doesn't go in the picture. Nossages. Hey, shut that thing off.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
All right.
Merry Christmas. Yeah, what are you guys going to get me?
I'll have to think of something.
Yeah. Merry Christmas, everybody!
Did you guess who was turning my camera on me? Well, I found some incriminating evidence on the tape.
An airplane so much in my whole life.